Namaskara. My name is Divya Ramesh. I'm the founder director of Safalya Music Academy here in Bay Area, California. I'm very thankful to Sampada Sabha for giving us this wonderful opportunity to present an educative program about Dasa Sahitya in their esteemed Sabha. Sampada has been involved in many wonderful initiatives, and we are really happy to be doing this program as part of educating the next generation of kids and creating awareness for traditional art forms. Dasa Sahitya is the literature of Bhakti movement, composed by devotees in honor of Lord Vishnu or one of his avatars. The Haridasas were wandering bards singing in praise of the Lord. They created a wave in the community, dwelling on the importance of practice of social values for spiritual attainment. The bhakti literature of these Haridasas is collectively referred to as Dasa Sahitya. Those were the days when common man, in particularly women folk, was prohibited from learning and speaking the language of gods, Sanskrit. This deprived them from the enormously rich, inspiring and spiritual teachings. The Haridasa Bhakti movement was pioneered by the great Narahari Tirtha and Sri Padarajaru during the 14th and 15th century in Karnataka. Bhakti movement considers the Lord as Samagana Priya. Bhakti through music is the most preferred path to reach him in Kali Yuga. Dasa Sahitya was enriched by the immense contribution of Yatis and Haridasas. It includes Devarnama, Suladis, Ugabogas, to name a few. The great scriptures were represented in the form of simple songs which a common man can understand. The first Madhva seer to write Dasa Sahitya or Devarnamas was Narahari Tirtharu, and he was followed by Sri Padarajaru. The credit for formalizing the Haridasa movement goes to Vyasaraya or Vyasarajaru, who founded the Vyasakuta and Dasakuta. The followers of Vyasakuta were learned yatis in the Vedas, Upanishads and scriptures. The Haridasas were learned in the Shastras and in Vyakarna and Shadangas and other components of Sanskrit. Both accepted Dvaita philosophy. The Vyasakuta was Gnanagamya focused. This meant they would focus on the philosophical aspects of the teachings of the masters, would unravel the confusion in the interpretation of the Vedic texts for the common man, and ignite the love for truth into a passion. The Haridasas, on the other hand, would sing the praises of Lord Vishnu through a more intelligible medium of the masses and would persuade people to follow the path of bhakti. Both the Kutas had the same end goal and used the forms of Kirtanas to convey the message of Dvaita philosophy as well as the love for the divine Lord Krishna to the common man who could not access and comprehend the scriptures. Sri Sri Padaraya, Vyasarajaru, Vadirajaru, Raghavendra Swami may be described primarily as belonging to the Vyasakuta, while Sri Purandradasa, Vijayadasa, Gopaladasa and Jagannathadasa as belonging to Dasakuta. There are several of hundreds of Dasas who have contributed to the Bhakti movement. However, today we have chosen few compositions of many great works to give you a glimpse of the Bhakti movement. Today, we start our presentation with a composition written by Sri Vyasarajaru. Let us know a little information about the composers. Sri Vyasarajaru was born to Sri Ramacharya and Sita Bai with the blessings of Sri Brahmanya Tirtharu. He was born without a bhus sparsha in the golden plate sent by him. His earlier education was held at Abur by Sri Brahmanya Tirtharu. Then after some time, Sri Brahmanya Tirtharu suggested that he go to Sri Padarajaru for higher education. At a very young age himself, he defeated many pundits in Kanchi, which was a very famous university for Vedanta studies, with his scholarly books. Sri Vyasarajaru was the Rajaguru for Krishna Devaraya, and he protected not only the king but also the entire kingdom with his advice. He adorned the throne of Vijayanagara for a few minutes to take upon himself an adverse combination of planets called Kuhu Yoga and gave back the empire to Krishna Devaraya. Sri Vyasarajaru has installed 732 Pranadevaru. Here, the Lord Hanuman is referred as Pranadevaru. When he was in Mulavagilu, he had a dream wherein he saw Mukhya Pranadevaru, who was shown as 732 Mukhya Prana idols. In Penugonda itself, he installed 365 Mukhya Pranadevaru on all the days of the year. In Adavani district, we can see 109 idols. Mulabagilu, Maddur, Mandya, Bannur, Mysore, etc. Speciality of the Mukhya Prana installed by Vyasaru is a bell on the tail of Hanuman. He worshipped Tirupati Timmappa for 12 years. When Tirupati Venkatesha temple Archakas started using the property jewels of Venkatesha for themselves, the king, who was the ardent devotee of Lord Venkateshwara, could not tolerate the misdeed and in fit of anger got all of them put to death. And there was no one for the puja at Tirupati. As such, Sri Vyasarajaru accepted the responsibility of doing puja for Tirupati Timmappa. After 12 years, he convinced the king that the duties should be handed over to the successor of the original priest's family, who was a little boy at that time. After getting the child Brahmopanayanam, he handed over the puja adhikara to the child once again. The famous Yantrodharaka Hanuman temple is also installed by Vyasaru. When Vyasaru was doing his japa near Chakratirtha, a monkey jumped out of a big rock and disappeared several times. Seeing this, Sri Vyasarajaru wrote a drawing of Pranadevaru on the rock, and a similar incident happened. So he wrote Shatkona and one circle in the area covering the Angara Hanuma and did 3 crore Bijakshara mantra japa and gave a special place for the Vigraha, which is now the famous temple. These are the few incidents. Without further delay, let's hear the rendition of such a great composer to start the program on Lord Ganesha. Gajamukhane Siddhidayakane, a beautiful composition praying Lord Ganesha to bestow upon us good knowledge.
Devadeva Nishara
rendition is a composition of Sripadarajaru. Sripada Tirtha was born to Seshagiriyappa and Giriyamma as Lakshmi Narayana in the year 1406. The name Sripadaraja was given to him by Sri Raghunatha Tirtharu, who was overwhelmed with the joy about his vidvat and praised Lakshmi Narayana Tirtharu and gave the title Sripadaraja. The same title became the name of Lakshmi Narayana Tirtharu. When Sripadarajaru was in Srirangam, he saw Tamil being used for offering prayers and Tamil compositions sung when people prayed at the Ranganatha Swami temple. Maybe inspired by that, Sripadaraja performed puja in Kannada, composed in Kannada, and even gave discourses in Kannada. He did all of this and more, and hence he is universally acknowledged as the Bhishma Pitamaha of Dasa Sahitya. He was a pioneer in writing Suladis in Kannada. Therefore, the second Renaissance starts with him, and this was continued further by his most beloved disciple Vyasarajaru. It is believed that the Lord used to dance to his songs. Sripadarajaru initially started composing under the pen name Gopinatha, and later his Ankita was Rangavithala. His Brindavana is in Narsimha Tirtha near Mulabagil on the Bangalore-Tirupati road. Vagvajra is the only work in Sanskrit. Some of his famous Devarnamas are Ni Ittange Iruveno Hariye, Kangali Dhyatako Kaveri Rangana Nodada. Today we are presenting Iko Node Ranganathana Puttapadava.
Iko Node Ranganathana Puttapadava. Iko Node Ranganathana Puttapadava. Iko Node Ranganathana Puttapadava. Sikkiteshi Lakshmi Padiya Divya Padava. Sikkiteshi Lakshmi Padiya Divya Padava. Iko Node Ranganathana Puttapadava.
Our next rendition is a composition of Shri Vadirajaru. Shri Vadirajaru was born with the blessings of Vagisha Tirtharu in Huvinakere. He was a pontiff of the Sode or Vadiraja Matha. He lived for 120 years and he was a contemporary of Purandaradasa, Kanakadasa, Sudhindra Tirtha and many others. He was an outstanding Sanskrit scholar, debater, poet, and his Rukminisha Vijaya is a masterpiece written in a span of 19 days with a good poetic excellence. He was a devotee of Hayagriva and he has composed many songs. His Ankita is Hayavadana. He has toured the entire Tirtha Kshetras in the country and has written a book called Tirtha Prabandha. When Vadirajaru visited Tirumala, the whole hill looked like a Saligrama to him. And so he climbed the hill on his knees and offered a garland of Saligrama to the Lord. Vadirajaru reformed the Paryaya system of the Sri Krishna Matha of Udupi from 2 months to 2 years, which is followed till date from the time of Acharya without any violation of rules. His Brindavana is in Sode near Sissi. He is one of the only two Madhva Yatis who has entered the Brindavana Sasharira, the other being Raghavendra Swami. The Brindavana is a very unique and it's known as Pancha Brindavana. There are four small ones around the main Brindavana, each one having the Sannidhana of Brahma, Vayu, Vishnu and Rudra. Vadirajaru has composed songs in Sanskrit and Kannada. Lakshmi Shobhane is a masterpiece which is recited even today in all marriages. Some of his popular compositions are Narayanayaniro, Govinda Gopala, Vani Paramakalyani and many more. Today, we are going to present Matu Matige Keshava, a song which depicts the message of instead of wasting the time chatting, it's better to chant the names of the Lord Vishnu. This song is composed in the raga Shuddha Saveri.
Oh, द्रौपदी सीरेया से लगा
of three great Dvaita saints of the Dasa movement, Sri Padarajaru, Vyasarajaru and Vadirajaru, who are collectively called Yatitrayaru. And now let's continue to know more about Sri Purandaradasaru, Kanakadasaru and Vijayadasaru, who form the great Dasa Trinity and whose compositions, popularly known as Devanamas, are sung even today in many occasions and concerts. Let us listen to a composition of Purandaradasa, Summane Dorakuvude, a composition which says it's not easy to chant the Harinama unless one surrenders to him completely.
Thank you.
Mom!
Vyasaru was born as Srinivasa Nayaka. He was the disciple of Vyasaraja and obtained Dikshe from him. As Srinivasa Nayaka, he was called Navakoti Narayana. He was a wealthy merchant known for his miserliness, renounced his wealth and took to the life of a dasa, understanding the ephemerality of the world. I'm sure many of them know the story of how he became Haridasa. He was an ardent devotee of Purandara Vithala. His compositions are a storehouse of musicology and poetry. He is called the father of Carnatic music. Sri Purandara Dasaru was the originator of the musical scale by which all the rules of Carnatic school are formed. His classification of Swaravali, Jantivarse, Alankara and Lakshana factors are accepted and practiced till date. His musical scheme was followed by all subsequent great composers of South India like Sri Venkatamaki, Sri Tyagarajaru, Sri Muthuswami Dikshitar, etc. Purandara Dasa is credited with creation of 475,000 compositions, although only a few hundreds survive till today. The songs of Purandara Dasa are very popular and many of them are sung every day, such as Jagadodharana, Bhagyada Lakshmi Baramma, Adisidalu Yashode, Tarakka Bindige, Yare Rangana, Yadava Neeva, Tamburi Meetidava, Ragi Tandira, and many others. Today, let's listen to Kava Deva Nee Nallave, a song which interprets that He is the Lord who protects us and this world.
Are ಶಾಸನ ಸಭೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಪತಿಗಳ ಇವರು ಎದುರಿ ನೋಡಿರಲು ಅತಿ ಚಪಲದೆ ದುಶಾಸನ ಸಭೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಪತಿಗಳ ಇವರು ಎದುರಿ ನೋಡಿರಲು ಮರಣ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಜಮಿಳ ಮರು ಕದಿ ತರಳ ನಾರಾಯಣನೆಂದು ಕರೆಯಲು ಮರಣ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಜಮಿಳ ಮರು ಕದಿ ತರಳ ನಾರಾಯಣನೆಂದು ಕರೆಯಲು ನೆರೆದು ಪೊರೆದು ಕರುಣಾಳುಗಳರ ಸನಿ ನೆರೆದು ಪೊರೆದು ಕರುಣಾಳುಗಳರ ಸನಿ ಗುರು ಪುರಂದರ ವಿಠಲ ಕರುಣದಿ ನೆರೆದು ಪೊರೆದು ಕರುಣಾಳುಗಳರ ಸನಿ ಗುರು ಪುರಂದರ ವಿಠಲ ಕರುಣದಿ ಕಾವದೇವ ನೀನಲ್ಲದೆ ಜಗಕ್ಕಿನ್ನವ ದೇವರುಂಟೆ ಕಾವದೇವ ನೀನಲ್ಲದೆ
Our next composition is Nityam Purushottamam, composed by Shri Kanakadasaru. He is a renowned poet, philosopher, musician and a prolific composer hailing from Kaginele in Haveri district. He was born in Bada village near Bankapura and was a warrior at Bankapura fort. Based on one of his compositions, it is interpreted as he was miraculously saved from a serious injury during the war, and after this incident, he gave up his job as a warrior and devoted himself to composing music and explaining philosophy to the common man. He was a disciple of Vyasatirtha and a contemporary of Purandaradasaru. He was a devotee of Adikeshava. His Ankita was Badadadi Keshava or Kaginele Adi Keshava. His compositions stress the need for cultivation of moral values in life. His story is a reminder that everyone is equal in the eyes of the Lord, and all that matters is devotion, dedication and sincerity. Kanakadasa has many popular songs such as Bhajisi Badukelo Manuja, Nee Maaye Olago, Bagilanu Teredu Seveyanu. His other works include Nala Charitre, Hari Bhakti Sara and Rama Dhyana Charitre, a rare work depicting the divisions between the rich and the poor.
ಗರಿ ಸ ನೀರ ಗರಿ ಸರಿ ಸೀರ ಪರಿ ಸ ನಿತ್ಯ ಪುರುಷೋತ್ತಮ
is Chiranjeeviyagilo Chinna Neenu, composed by Vijayadasaru. Vijayadasaru was initiated into the Haridasa fold by Purandaradasa himself. Purandaradasaru came in Vijayadasaru's dream and took him to Vyasakashi, where Vedavyasa wrote the Akshara Vijaya on his tongue. From then on, Vijayadasaru went on to write innumerable songs in praise of Hari. Vijayadasaru has composed 25,000 songs. His thorough grasp of Shastra is evident through his works and unique scholarly style full of Sanskrit words. In addition to this, he is affectionately called Dasa Shrestha for his personality, knowledge, and the brilliant disciples he has left behind. This particular song was composed when Vijayadasaru prevented a woman from killing herself and her son and looked after them as part of his family. That boy later became his disciple and a very famous Haridasa called Mohanadasa. Sri Vijayadasaru even demonstrated his amazing powers by making a dimwit recite and explain Jayatirtha's Sriman Nyaya Sudha in simple words. It must be noted here that this was a feat which even very learned scholars found impossible to do. The location where his Aradhane is celebrated in Chipgiri is called Sri Vijayadasara Katte. Many people believe that Sri Purandaradasaru composed a total of 4,75,000 literary pieces in his lifetime, and when Madhvapati pointed out to his father he was 25,000 short of 5 lakh, Sri Purandaradasaru told him that by the grace of Vijaya Vittala, Madhvapati would be reborn as a Haridasa in the next birth and make up the balance 25,000. Accordingly, Madhvapati, the son of Sri Purandaradasaru, was reborn as Sri Vijayadasa in his next birth and composed 25,000 songs with the Ankita of Sri Vijaya Vittala.
Bye. ಕೂಡೆ ಮಾತಾಡಲಿ ಬೇಡ, ನಿನ್ನ ಕರ ಕಣ್ಣೇದಿ ನೋಡಬೇಡ, ಮಂದ ಮತಿಗಳ ಕೂಡೆ ಮಾತಾಡಲಿ ಬೇಡ, ನಿನ್ನ ಕರ ಕಣ್ಣೇದಿ ನೋಡಬೇಡ. ಇಂದಿರೆಯರ ಶ್ರೀ ವಿಜಯ ವಿಠಲನ ಚರಣ, ಇಂದಿರೆಯರ ಶ್ರೀ ವಿಜಯ ವಿಠಲನ ಶರಣ, ದ್ವಂದ್ವದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಸಗವನಿಡದಿರಬೇಡ. ಇಂದಿರೆಯರಸ ಶ್ರೀ ವಿಜಯ ವಿಠಲನ ಶರಣ, ದ್ವಂದ್ವದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಸಗವನಿಡದಿರಬೇಡ. ಚಿರಂಜೀವಿಯಾಗಿರೋ ಚಿಂತನೀನು, ಜೀವಿಯಾಗಿರೋ ಚಿನ್ನ ನೀನು,
ಅವರ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ದಾಸೋಹಂ ತವ ದಾಸೋಹಂ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ರಿಟನ್ ಬೈ ಜಗನ್ನಾಥ ದಾಸರು. ಜಗನ್ನಾಥ ದಾಸರು ವಾಸ್ ಬೋರ್ನ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಬ್ರಾಹ್ಮಿನ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ. Even at a young age, his brilliance was very evident. As such, he grew up to be a very great Sanskrit scholar who was very well versed in all the great Dvaita works. Unfortunately, he also developed an intense dislike for Haridasas. Having an ego about his knowledge and dislike of the Haridasas of that time, he ended up learning his mistake through the hard way. Soon after, Srinivasa felt intense disgust at his own arrogance and rushed to Sri Vijayadasaru, deeply regretting his past behavior and mistakes. Sri Gopala Dasaru gave him Haridasa Dikshe and directed him to Pandarapura for Ankita, wherein he received the pen name Jagannatha Vitthala. From that day onwards, he started composing devotional works with that Ankita and became renowned as Jagannatha Dasaru. Through his life incidents, it is revealed that he was an Aparoksha Jnani and a great Bhakta who was able to perform many Leelas with the Lord. The jewel in his devotional crown was Harikathamrita Sara, which is one of the most important works in Vaishnava literature. It is in this wonderful work Sri Jagannatha Dasaru captured the essence of his amazing grasp of Shastras, Srimad Acharya's works, as well as the works of other great Dvaita saints. Sri Jagannatha Dasa was a writer known chiefly for his prodigious scholarship in Sanskrit and a mastery of original Sanskrit texts of the system. His style is highly Sanskritized and his work poetizes bhakti in a very comprehensive style. His magnum opus, the Harikathamrita Sara, encompasses the great Indian philosophical writings of the Vedas, the Upanishads and the Gita. Sri Jagannatha Dasa's works are considered to be compositions that have a lot of implicit meaning of life and its teachings. Let's listen. Dasoham Tava Dasoham.
ಸೋಹಂ ವಾಸುದೇವ ನಿಗತ
Literature of Haridasas is so vast to embrace all the aspects of Indian culture. The essence of Upanishads, Puranas, Vedas, Bhagavata have been brought to us through the rich literature of Haridasas. They have been successful in spreading the didactic teachings in a musical form to the hearts of the common man. It is difficult to separate literature, music, and devotion from their works. They have made an indelible impression on not just the religious and cultural heritage of Karnataka, but also the cultural history of India. Today, many Dasa Sahitya projects and activities are growing to propagate and popularize these priceless gems. We are very thankful to Sampada Sabha for giving us this wonderful opportunity to present the glimpse of the works of Haridasas. We end today's presentation with Vaidyana Na Ariye Bhava Roga Ke Vaidyanu Ni Hariye, one of the compositions written by Sri Purandaradasaru. It is a very, very apt composition for today's time, which we are going through this pandemic. The Vaidya is only the Lord Hari. He has to find the solution and get us all back to the normal life. Thank you. Namaskara.
Oh, दिव्य।